Okay, hello. So today, this is we are doing this is Smashing Pumpkins and Perfect, and we're gonna see what this is all about. This is normally a lyrics video because I've noticed that lyrics videos don't have the same sound quality as like a video from the actual YouTube channel of the band. So I'd rather have sound quality over the lyrics, I guess. But I have the lyrics here on another screen anyway, so I know what Billy will be saying. So anyway, let's just get on with this and see what it's all about. Okay, so Perfect by Smashing Pumpkins from the album Adore. So yeah, I mean, I want to say I liked Billy's voice a lot in this one. I know it's always his voice, he can be feral or he can make his voice soft and pretty, and I like how he had like a soft and pretty voice here, and he never screamed or anything like that. It was just very soothing, very nice. I like that. So I guess go down on the about of the song on genius.com. So it says the second and final commercial single. So there's only two commercial singles off of the album Adore from 1998. Perfect is in many ways a sister song to the band's biggest hit, 1979, from Rolling Stone magazine, stating that it picks up on the synth pop echoes of the 1996 Pumpkins hit to the music video, which is a sequel to 1979. Okay, so I never knew that part. I haven't seen the music video, but I have seen like a picture, the thumbnail for the music video where Billy is wearing a cowboy hat. So that intrigues me. But anyway, yeah, I guess I'll get into some annotations here. I see this is pretty popular. There's like 28,000 views on this Genius page, and the music video has quite a few million views as well. So, I mean, it was a successful single, it seems. So, with the first verse, I know we're just like old friends, we just can't pretend the lovers make amends. We are reasons so unreal, we can't help but feel that something has been lost. So it says, time causes change in all of us. It is in the last line of the first verse that the subject of the song is declared, that being the effect that time, excuse me, the effect that time has had on both the narrator and his ex-lover. Shortly before Adore was released, I keep burping, my goodness, Billy Corgan used the same phrase when speaking to his fans. He already recognized there would be many people out there who would criticize him for changing, which is an unavoidable effect of time. So this is what Billy said. We could do all the things that people seem to like now, but remember that we did them then when those things were not so popular. If you feel that something has been lost, then that is what you feel. Remember that it is you too who are changing, and that us changing may remind you a lot, may remind you of a change or of a future that you might not want. All good things come to an end, so let us begin again fresh. Have faith. And might do us all some good. So okay, so this is all about changing, I guess. That whole quote, there's a lot of changing going on, and I noticed that there's a change here when I was looking through the personnel on the song, and that Jimmy Chamberlin is not on drums. And I do remember seeing something that he left the band at some point, and yeah, that's what I noticed as well. Just seeing, I was seeing the personnel as I was reading that quote. So yeah, it's just a little thing there that I noticed. So going on to more annotations. So it says, Angel, you know it's not the end. We'll always be good friends. So the simple directness and seeming sincerity of these lines, in fact, make them a scathing snark on the subject of love. While the lyrics and vocal cadences sound pure, the lyrics are deeply sarcastic. Okay, so I'm not surprised. Corgan told Howard Stern, the song is about people starting off a relationship with the best intentions. It doesn't work out. That uneasy thing where you can't be friends anymore. Corgan also writes in the Adore liner notes, to state the obvious, the lyric is meant as ironic, as little in love's affairs can be quantified as perfect, yet this is the goal. So, yeah, so I'm not surprised that he was being a little tongue-in-cheek there. And the last annotation is just about the outro of him repeating perfect. So it says, this video for the song follows the lives of the kids from the 1979 video. In the final shots of the video for perfect, we see the bootleg tape of a Pumpkins concert recorded by one of the characters slide from the roof of his car. This echoes how the original tapes of footage of house party scene in 1979 were lost in a similar way. So yeah, again, this whole song kind of is reminiscent or follows 1979, which is kind of cool to see. And obviously I don't think the song is was as big as 1979, so yeah, but I mean 1979, that was a huge song. That's probably the first Pumpkin song I really heard, and it's just such a nice little tune. So anyway, yeah, this was 1998. So yeah, and that 1979 came out like 2 years earlier, it said. And this is Adore, not Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness. So this was a different time. There was changes going on, like Billy Corgan said. And I guess people probably, maybe they didn't like what they heard, how they changed up. It's not really. I guess apparently they might have changed up their sound from what Billy is saying. I don't know anything about the song, but yeah, well, I do know stuff about the song now. But I mean, I wasn't a Pumpkins fan in 1995 or whatever. I wasn't even born. So anyway, I guess that's it. Yeah, so changes can be a good thing, as Billy says, and you know, relationships can be a good thing too. But unless you're not in love anymore and you can't be friends, tough luck. So anyway, I guess that's it. Thanks for watching. Thanks for liking and subscribing and commenting and all that kind of thing. I really appreciate it. And yeah, thanks for watching. Really do appreciate it. So I'll see you guys again soon, and yeah, have a great one. Okay.